Welcome back friends. In this video, we will make a very basic mind map of nitrates, a group of drugs commonly used in angina. Let's start. Drugs in nitrate group are glycerol trinitrate or nitroglycerin, isosorbide dinitrate, isosorbide mononitrate, pentaerythritol tetranitrate, and erythritol tetranitrate. Let's see mechanism of action and effects of these drugs. They generate nitric oxide in body. Nitric oxide activates cytosolic guanylyl cyclase, which increases cGMP level. This causes smooth muscle relaxation at multiple sites in body. Main effect is venodilatation. This decreases venous return, leading to decreased end diastolic volume. Resultant decrease in preload decreases cardiac workload. There is also some arteriolar dilatation. This decreases total peripheral resistance, resulting in decreased afterload. This also contributes in decreased cardiac work. Gastrointestinal and biliary tract smooth muscles also get relaxed. Increased cGMP level in platelets decreases platelet aggregation. Now let's talk about pharmacokinetics. First, absorption. When given by oral route, they undergo extensive first-pass metabolism in liver. Exception in this is isosorbide mononitrate, which undergo a little first-pass metabolism. Sublingual route avoids first-pass metabolism and produces quick response. Coming to duration of action. Glycerol trinitrate is very short-acting with plasma half-life of about 2 minutes. All other nitrates are comparatively longer-acting. Now let's move to uses of nitrates. They are used in angina. For acute attack of angina, glycerol trinitrate is given by sublingual route. For chronic prophylaxis, long-acting nitrates are given orally. In classical angina, they provide benefit by reducing oxygen demand by decreasing cardiac work, as we have seen in mechanism of action. In variant angina, dilatation of coronary artery improves oxygen supply to heart. Other uses are congestive heart failure, esophageal spasm, biliary colic, and cyanide poisoning. These were the uses. Now let's see adverse events with nitrates. A common adverse event is headache due to dilatation of meningeal vessels. Next is hypotension due to vasodilatation. Postural hypotension leading to weakness and dizziness occur with nitrates. High dose of nitrates can cause excessive hypotension leading to activation of baroreceptor reflex. This causes tachycardia, which can worsen angina. Next adverse event is facial flushing due to arteriolar dilatation in face and neck. They can also cause methemoglobinemia. Finally, development of tolerance is also a big problem with nitrates. It possibly occurs due to reduced generation of nitric oxide. It can be prevented by nitrate-free interval of 8 to 12 hours a day. So these were the adverse events. Now last point, interactions. Phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitors like sildenafil increase the cGMP level and thereby potentiate the response of nitrates. So be careful about it. This completes our mind map of nitrates. You can download it from our Facebook page facebook.com/nonstopneuron. Find the link in description. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your study partners too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.